Hi, my name is Demitri. In this video, we're going to dive into the top three Notion alternatives in 2024. So for those of you that are unaware, Notion is a very good product. It's a product that a lot of people enjoy on a daily basis. They project manage, they note take test manage, they do a lot of things. They brainstorm, they collaborate, they use templates and purchase courses like my course, Mastering Notion. It's a course that helps many people. And if you want to get it for free, you can purchase any of my templates down below that are on the premium side. But with that being said, if you don't want to use Notion, there are a lot of other options out there for you. Like for example, ClickUp, which is the first option on the list. Now, they have done an entire rebrand to their website to stop making themselves look like a bunch of people who just can't stop being braggarts. They were very braggadocious for a while. If you went on Twitter, it was disgusting how much they would brag. But now they have a really great product here that is in a more digestible format. I, for one, very much enjoy the layout of ClickUp 3.0. It's a little bit less congested. The sizing of things can be updated pretty well. And what I like about ClickUp is that they do have a free forever plan, which is great. Talks about how many megabytes of storage you have, the fact that you can use collaborative docs, whiteboards, and a myriad of different views. And then if you want to upgrade to the unlimited plan, which is good for small teams, you get unlimited storage, email inside of ClickUp, which is really cool. You have the ability to even add SSO on top of it, better time tracking and automations for that business plan, I think is really cool. But this is essentially a very souped up project management oriented version of Notion. A lot of the different automations and stuff are awesome. If you go here, you can see that you can create automations that when something happens in a task, you can change a status, change a bunch of different items inside of ClickUp, whether it be a priority status gets changed, you know, if to high if due date arrives, right? Something like that. It's really cool. I'm very happy with the high level stuff inside of ClickUp, but I'm also very happy with the basics. I mean, they have everything from list, Gantt, calendar, documents, board, and tables. As you can see here, it's a very similar look to what you'd get from most project management type software. And you can select in a similar way to like the table view and Notion. So it's actually a pretty familiar experience for a lot of things. What it has that Notion doesn't is definitely the whiteboard feature. Being able to create a whiteboard, like this project workflow whiteboard inside of the platform. Like I just really enjoy the fact that I can go through here and create a project workflow. They have a bunch of different templates to choose from. Like a flow chart right here for this workflow. I think it's awesome. Like if I could have this inside of Notion, I would be pretty happy. I won't lie. I think ClickUp is a great alternative to Notion in a lot of ways. I just gave them a lot of flack for a while because they were so braggadocious and then didn't drop ClickUp 3.0 for way too long. So hopefully they kind of come back in the space in a better way. Now, number two on my list is definitely Coda. Coda is a really cool tool. The product itself is not actually usable as a downloadable application. As you can see, they keep asking about it and, you know, people just never really get the answer they want. However, fun tip, you can just open the site as a window and it feels like a desktop experience. So like, I don't wanna say get over it per se, but if there was something to get over, this could be on the list of things to do that for. It's a really cool tool. It's essentially a collaborative doc environment. The free plan is actually pretty great. You have unlimited doc size for unshared documents. And then if you get into the sharing size of things, you need to actually pay for it. There's a bunch of different free packs, which are essentially integrations. I'd say this is one of the better integration platforms. And as you can kind of see here with this, as you go up in tier, the data refreshes at different rates, like the team plans hourly, pro plans daily. It is expensive, by the way, for the team plan. $30 per month is expensive. But if you utilize the tools, it's like, all right, I can see how it's worth the money. It has webhooks. It has things that Notion doesn't have. It's a more technical version of it. Like, for example, we go to manage templates here. You can check out any template to get started. Let's just show something that's like a project managey sort of thing. As you can see right here, it does have a bit of a more condensed view to it. However, you can kind of open up the page here. So this sidebar is very similar to what you'd see in another platform like Notion or otherwise. But in order to take a look at this, you'll notice the styling I like, actually. It was a little bit more clunky prior, but they've kind of improved it. They have a bunch of different fields. I mean, they have so many different fields. They're doing a great job. They have reactions, they have buttons, they have, and buttons, by the way, do a great job because they can sometimes pretty much serve as automations. They can relate to other tables. They change this to relation from the term lookup if you're familiar with the platform, and the relation is very similar to what a rollup is in another platform that we like to call Notion. And then packs, once again, you can actually just integrate stuff here. Like you can browse all the different packs. You can email a page quickly. You can integrate your Google Calendar, your Google Drive. There's so many good integrations on this. Linear, Airtable, I really like it. Some of them are by Coda, and some people have made their own custom packs. Like this Airtable one isn't even by Coda itself. So I love this. It's definitely a much better integration experience than Notion. And when it comes to the settings for the page, let's go to page options, and I'm going to make the page width wide, because previously this narrow view, I just don't like it. So let's just go to wide view, and you can change it to a full size here as well. If you want to make it like a true full size, you press full, and then this is something that's relatively new to Coda. And you actually have full pages. As you can see right here, there's multiple different databases and views. Adding new rows is actually really nice. I'd say some platforms do a really poor job of even just adding a new row, and that might be something weird to you, but the fact that you can click on it, and if I click off, it doesn't like disappear. I don't like that functionality. It's a preference of mine. Like Smart Suite doesn't have that ability to like just click off and it's new. And then it has to have like a unique record name. Not really the case. With this, we can do like purple. As you can see right here, they also have something that's very unique in comparison to Notion, which is rich text editing to a certain extent within here. Like I can highlight the text background here while it being in a field. That's cool as heck, right? I can bold it while it being in a field as well. All these things, sometimes you can do in Notion, sometimes you can't. So I can bold it, change the color as well to purple, which is really cool. Yeah, from here you can see it's pretty similar. I mean, press this button, it did something you can do in Notion now, but this is definitely more advanced. The formulas in Coda are a lot better. I'd play around with it. It's a cool platform. Now, last but not least on the list, we're actually gonna show you Capacities, which is pretty cool of a platform. It's new. It's definitely something that I've reviewed on the channel before, but haven't touched on, and I wanna get more into it as we kind of niche down into this segment of the market. It's a really cool platform just for the fact that it seems to pull from a lot of the different concepts of the other tools, while being unique in its own right. Like I do think it's important to note that a lot of these tools really pull from each other and none of them are that unique, but they all have their own idiosyncrasies that I like. So for free, you have unlimited spaces, objects, and blocks. Like they have all made free plans that are ridiculous, I'd have to say, in these SaaS companies. Like the value that these companies provide for us now, I think most people need to appreciate a little bit more. Software doesn't need to be free. I mean, there's people with companies that need to make money. So I really appreciate what they do, honestly. And for that free plan, you also get the ability to import and export, which really makes it great for adding new stuff to the system. Unlimited custom object types, which is great. You do have to pay for the mobile app, which is a weird experience, because it's on early access, but this is the thing for other apps, like with Morgan, my calendar app, it's another thing. And they're still kind of working on giving you access to things like tables and formulas for tables and stuff on the pro plan. So they give you a lot, but then it's almost more like a glorified text editor at the basic level. And then if you want to pay a little bit more, you'll get access to betas and stuff. The product itself, basically notes don't really live in folders. They're just like all connected with each other. Kind of has a similar like graph view to something you'd maybe see in another product like Obsidian, which is why a lot of people like it. Everything is essentially an object, right? So they're not just thousands of faceless pages. Everything is an object in Capacities. There are images, meetings, ideas, people, all those sort of things. And then things are essentially connected inside of the platform. So it's a bit of a mix between Notion and Obsidian in the way that you'd probably understand what the platform is. As you can see right here on the left, the objects are automatically categorized into things like web links, images, pages. However, you can add new types like person, meeting, Zettle, which is like an atomic note system, projects, organizations, a bunch of different types, and those are unlimited. As mentioned previously, the tables are something you need for Capacities Pro, but say for example, we wanted to add a project here and press use template, then you could go in here and you'll see if I click on this, it has a very similar feel to Notion and Coda in some ways where you click in it and then there's properties and stuff. So I can use any of these properties like a single select property, like status, right? And I can change the icon to whatever I want. So I could be like, use an emoji, or if you're on premium, you can use curated icon sets. So I'm just gonna put checkbox as like a little status emoji right here. And I can change this to be anything I'd want. So I could be like in progress, completed, and something along the lines of not started. So then I could select one of these like in progress. And if I wanted to as well with this, you'll see that it actually opens up and showcases all the different content that actually has this connected to it. So you can add pages, projects, many different things to this. And you could also change the icon of the in progress item too, which is cool. And you can change the color. So I don't really like that. I'm a big green. You can also add different collaborators, start date, end date. All these properties are great. I mean, they're very similar. The block one's interesting because you can essentially just reference it to any other block type, which I like a lot. And then it's like referencing a property in here. It's pretty cool. If you press backslash here, you'll notice that there's a lot of different great markdown functionality like math and multiple columns and even a little mini table and stuff. Notion didn't have tables for a while. Grouping things together, a lot of different great options. You can also full page this if you want it to look better and remove the sidebar or show the sidebar. A lot of cool options, right? Like, I think this is a great product. It just is gonna take a little bit of time for people to get, you know, their bearings on it. It's definitely like similar to the other products, but as I said, there's just like a little bit of a different way that the structure of everything works. Like everything in Notion is a page, whereas everything in here is like an object, as it said. So it's a little bit different. So if you like this video and want to see more content on how to improve your skills using productivity tools even more, make sure to check out other content like this one on my channel right here.